This is Salamancer. You're watching SalTV, Competitive Team Fortress 2, and I'm just going to lift this comment straight from the stream chat, because when I put this heavy on air, people liked it. This is Schweeb saying, "That heavy looks like he will take your woman, fly to the moon, and give your mother the night of her life in Paris." That is this heavy right here, and it is actually London Calling. We're going to be casting a game between the Mexican Cat Ranch and Costco. Blue, of course, being the Cat Ranch, and red, the Team Costco. I do like the Costco Club name. It looks like people are looking to get bargains right now. And, oh, nice work actually by the Pyro, keeping those sticky bombs away from the heavy. Could have taken a lot more damage than you really wanted to. Let's just take a look at the bird's eye view of this battle for a little while. It looks like Blue Team has actually invaded a little bit into their opponent's hallway here. And they will grab the intel, but not for long as... Spy is going for the stab. He does manage to get it, grabbing the intel. He's going to start trying to walk upstairs. Medic not quite able to keep up with him. However, this is a good defense coming in from the red team. I like they were able to hold on to this intel here for so long. I'm going to have to do a lot more third-person view, I think, in this mode than I am with any other, just because we're going to have to keep up with the intel quite a lot, and that will change hands quite a bit. Interesting sticky trap here. I don't know if Ricky's trap is actually... I could probably deal some damage to people. But yeah, there is going to be a lot of fighting over here right now as the blue team tries to reposition themselves, get in there and take the intel once again. They're probably not going to be able to do it though, as there is now a sentry going up. So yeah, Turbine Pro. This is actually a legit map mode for competitive. We're waiting to see whether the sticky trap actually hits the med. Oh no, it's not going to hit that at all. In fact, I kind of want to see that happen, but it's not going to. Intel does get grabbed, and that's actually a really impressive Uber push. They managed to push a lot of people in behind the Uber, and usually if you're not getting Ubered and you're walking into like a heavy or something, you're just like, I don't want to do that, I'm going to die. But no, they used the Uber to body block, and then everybody else just kind of walked away. Oh, poor soldier. Everybody else walked right behind it, and so they were able to push ahead of the intel with the Uber, grab the intel, and now that is going to be the first capture of the game for the Mexican Cat Ranch. Oh, watch out, Cat Ranch. You are about to get your head of your medic sniped off. And this is Cat Friend, who is at one health and is, yes, going to die. It's a good pick. It does mean that our red team here, Costco, could potentially get an attack together of their own. And they are going to be going up through the same route their opponents took. It is, of course, the quickest route to the intel, straight out of that mid. And that's a difference from the stock pub version of this map. And this version. Sakura is ready to go with the Uber. Oh! That was actually really close. One more sticky and he would have died. Got down to about 50 health, but that's okay. They did milk the Uber quite a bit. They're going to walk in here, and there's only mini sentries guarding the intel, so they should be able to get in and grab it, but they aren't yet for some reason. They're having difficulty right now pushing effectively. That partly is because, of course, there's sticky traps, there's rockets all over the place. Nobody able to get in without dying so far. The soldier does try, but no! Nice sticky trap on the ground in front of that intel is going to take out the soldier, and now our red team is losing a whole bunch of players. Now the spy, of course, does get away, and he's going to make that pyro just so frustrated. I tell you, as a pyro, playing against those spicicle spies is frustrating. It's frustrating as crap. I hate doing it. But yeah, Tin Kelp here, this is an interesting defense of the mini sentries. The self-sustaining Mexican Cat Ranch. They are not too worried about having those level 3s. I wonder if this is kind of a new metagame shift here, because this is UGC Platinum. This is Platinum Highlander. We're going to check and see what the sentry looks like in here. And there isn't one. Maybe it is all about the mini sentries. Although, actually, the sentry, yeah, no, it is. It's outside. It's outdoors. So it does look like Costco in the red. They want to... I'm sorry. Is that Costco in the... Yeah, it's in the red. They do want to hold the middle area here. That's why they have the NG out here with the mini sentry trying to deal damage from across the map. He's going to jump down and go for the pick on the med. He does manage to get it, and that is going to be pretty important as now Lambert trying to get away from this enemy scout. He'll probably, oh no, doesn't get taken out. Grabs a health kit. Should be able to actually cap the intel here. This is some pretty impressive scout play right now. 9 health left. Got to watch out for this sniper. One body shot and he is toast, but no, he gets away with it. Finally taken down. Well, he took down 2 or 3 players along with him, and this spy actually kind of brought the intel the wrong way here. That's okay, though, as the demo man and spy of the blue team are actually going to have to back away. Good play, though, so far by the Costco Club. They're probably going to get their first capture of the night here as long as they can manage to push all the way back to their own intel. This is so weird, though. Like, in 6v6, it is exactly the opposite. You're never going to, like, abandon your own intel room. But in this case, that seems to be exactly what's happening. Interesting positioning here by Lambert once again. And he does manage to pick off the med. Gonna Actually, I thought he was going to go for the sniper here. And he does. There you go. Okay, so he's just being a little weird. Not going to get away with that one. But now we've got Sakura actually pushing up with his heavy. Sakura has played medic and intermediate. He knows his positioning fairly well. Although he will have to back away. Doesn't like how his heavy died there. But no, Sakura actually has played medic and intermediate. He's one of my friends. One of my friends. He has, of course, played intermediate. I started casting, and then I had to mute myself to cough and didn't unmute myself. So I casted about 20 seconds of this game without a microphone. My bad. But yeah, Sekiro used to be the scheduler for XTV, so he helped us get games together and get casters for the games. So he actually decides that that spy needs to die, so I like that. I don't think he got the kill, but he definitely helped. Now they are, it looks like they are allowing enemies into their intel room though. Scout's gonna go straight for it, and there is an engineer in here though. And it seems like that is a regular level 1 sentry, so it will take down Prevail. Problem is, the engineer's down now. So if blue team manages to get in there and do any damage at all, it's gonna be really good for them. But interestingly, the intel is actually out here. And so the cat ranch, they're not gonna have an easy time of grabbing it. I once asked, you know, what's the deal with the name Self-Sustaining Mexican Cat Ranch? And I actually got to find out when Hein came to town. He came to Houston the other day. Uh-oh! Good try. That is actually going to keep the intel in the same position for a little while longer, so it gives the blue team a little bit more ability to push in and try to grab it again. Hein was in town, though, and he was saying that the name of the team, it was just come up with on Mumble one day when somebody was like, well, you could have a Self-Sustaining Cat Ranch in Mexico, where, ooh, Pepe with the nice headshots. Where, like, the cats have so many baby cats that they can just, you know, they can just eat the cats and you can have more and more cats. that was the whole gist of the story. That is where the Self-Sustaining Mexican Cat Ranch came from. So it's pretty gross, but that's how it works. Tin Kelp, the engineer, actually came out here to grab the intel. So things looking up right now. Not sure why the dispenser is over here. I'm not sure who's going to use that, but I know he has his reasons. It's a level 3 dispenser, and it... Uh-oh. We're going to see this game tie up again, probably, as that is going to be... Is that Lambert again? No, I think it's the other way around. It's the other scout. Interestingly, red team now down a man. No, it is Lambert. Totally is Lambert. Lambert, the friendly lion, right? Is that right? And he will get back to the embracing bosom of the rest of his team and probably be able to cap this intel again. So that is going to tie things up, I think. The Cat Ranch, yeah, not going to have any kind of advantage right now. In fact, they've got a disadvantage because of where the red team is positioned. They're positioned on top of their intel. They could still get out here and try to cap it, but it's actually going to be tougher and tougher as the entire red team is just going to be balled up around this, looking for enemies to walk out of any chokes. They do have an eye over here. Definitely watching this very, very carefully. Of course, the blue demo up there, that's Warpy, was trying to get some damage done up top, but I don't think it's going to happen too much. Now, he did take down Lambert. Oh, sorry, we've got to use a lot of third-person camera today. Thank you, Heavy. No, the intel is just about to actually drop off, and this scout realizing, no, I can't really get away with that. Pepe gets taken down by Insom. That's a good one. Warpy jumping out here again, though, and he forces an Uber drop. That's kind of a big deal. He didn't get away with getting the capture, so that's going to be too bad. But he at least got an Uber drop out of that, so he's pretty happy. Now the Mexican Cat Ranch should be able to do some damage here and get in and try to capture, but I don't know if they can. They're actually backed up into their own intel right now. Lambert deciding he is just going to try and sneak around to the intel. He's like, hey, whatever, Heavy. Actually, he's not just doing that. He's using this bonk for something more interesting, which, oh! Okay, that is a crits. No, he was using that for something a lot more interesting, which is to say that he was trying to body block for his demo man against that heavy. So he's trying to take all the damage instead of the demo man taking it. Now there is a nice little sentry position there. It does get taken down, not really doing too much damage, but it took a lot of attention because of that Wrangler. Problem is, attention doesn't matter when the only three people left alive on your team are going to have to turtle up on the point as hard as they possibly can. There is no way they're going to be able to stop this capture. I'm almost certain. Not even the manliest heavy in the world can stop this. He does spot the scout. So, I mean, if blue team, if the Mexican Cat Ranch doesn't actually come in a coordinated fashion, then I guess they're not going to get it. I thought they could actually coordinate a really good push there, but it looks like they're just content with capturing mid right now. That is going to be a pyro taken out. Monkey suit is disguising. That engineer, he's going to know, dude. He knows it's you. Oh, he doesn't see you. Oh, nice monkey suit with the jukes. And he doesn't even have to worry about sapping too much. He just wants to get the intel. That is the most important thing right now. I'm going to start walking it upstairs. And if he can give it to his soldier, actually, that's what I would do, is just hand it to the soldier. But whatever. Going to go ahead and use the dead ringer. And if his fellow soldier does die, that doesn't even matter. Now, what does matter is if he gets spotted decloaking, and that's going to be a problem. Still good attempt at a capture here now by Lambert. Once again, he is going to start trying to juke this, but I don't know if that's going to work too well. The Pyro has now managed to stick him up into that corner. Finishing off the kill was Pepe. We need to watch Pepe some more, but actually, yeah, watch Pepe some more. Where are you? Taking a lot of hits, but he should be okay for now. Watching, he's watching this one hallway here, which is actually a really good place to watch, because if you can do that as the Slamper, you're going to be shutting down quite a bit of the enemy's play style. Monkey suit taken down, but that is just a dead ringer. He is still alive. Still going to be trying to steal things, stab backs. And now Pepe's getting really aggressive here. He spots people, decides to cover them in Pepe, and then retreat. Like that choice. And in comes the crits. Highlander Antoine taken down right away. Insom taken down. This is a good crit so far, but there is not going to be anything left for it. Now, there is a heavy still standing in here. There's actually a level 3 sentry wrangled. This is the kind of defense you normally see on an intel room. Scout standing up here and watching it all unfold, though, and nobody's really paying attention to him yet. Interesting Uber pop, and that is going to mean that they will get away with this. But the scout, he's thinking about trying to get in there and get the capture. But no, he actually is just going to stand back and watch the enemy's cap. That's kind of too bad. He's feeling a little sad up here. Prevail, I feel sorry for you. Oh, perfect opportunity. The engineer actually picked up and moved a sentry. And the scout, he doesn't hear the beeps anymore. He wants to get in here and cap this intel. Do it, Prevail, do it. He grabs it. Perfect perch, perfect waiting time and opportunity. And he will just waltz this all the way out to mid. Now, of course, he is going to have a problem with some people respawning. But Lambert drops the intel, and the scout's getting out to mid. Nobody's spotting him yet, even though the little indicator should tell them exactly where it is. He's going to try to walk upstairs, and he should get away with this. This is perfect play by Prevail. Prevail, we're watching you on this entire intel run. He's getting it all the way back. And there you go, Prevail with the... Prevailing over... I don't even know what to say. Whoa, okay, so it looks like our engineer may have actually died or something. Intel being guarded right now by the blue team. I was told to watch Warpy. The scouts are doing a really good job this game, but I'm going to try to find that demo man. Because Warpy, I mean, he seems to be making some really big plays already. He has, of course, forced a drop. And there you go. That is going to actually be Ricky jumping in with the Uber, taking out a bunch of stuff. Not able to finish off that sentry, though. And actually, the sentry is now wrangled, which is going to make it that much harder. There's only 3 players for life for the blue team. And there's actually a lot of damage going down onto this heavy. He does not like the fact that there is a wrangled sentry there. Even though it was on fire, he actually could have killed that really easily. He had 300 health. I think he could have gotten away with it. But then he saw the sniper as well. That was probably what really scared him away, was the sniper. And Attila the Bum taking down Sakura. It's been so long since I have had Attila the Bum on this channel. Last time was... What? Oh, what even match was that? What even grammar was that? I don't even remember. It was Attila, though. Oh, it was on Steel. It was on CP Steel. So that was a good one, Attila. And I am very glad to see you once again in Highlander. Tearing it up on the sniper. He's actually getting in a little bit of trouble here, though. He's going to get chased down by a scout and a spy. Looking for the headshot. Not going to get it, Attila. Sorry, that was not Attila's strong suit. Attila, actually, in the olden days, rode on a horse and shot things with a bow and arrow and then hit them with a sword. That was Attila. Although Attila the Bum, a little bit different. We're talking about Attila the Hun. So Attila the Bum occasionally rode on the back of a truck and, you know, occasionally shot things with giant loogies. That was Attila the Bum. So still not really the kind of skill you would expect to see in a sniper. But you know, he does pretty well. Right now though, of course, 4-5, you can tell at the bottom there. I'm just going to kind of narrate the score for a little bit. Oh, it's 4-5 in favor of the Costco Club. And Costco controls mid right now. It seems to be that controlling mid isn't that important in 9v9, and of course it is important, but oh, nice reflect there to save the med, of course. It is important, but it's not as important in 6v6, where in 6v6 it's sort of like you're defending your last point if the enemy holds mid. But in 9v9, you can sneak all kinds of stuff around, especially because all the weapons are allowed, so you can, or pretty much all of them, you You can use Bonk, you can use the Spicycle to get around Pyros, you can do all kinds of stuff that you otherwise would not be able to do. And there's so many of you that if one of you goes missing on defense, it's not really that big of a deal. So, now, the Mexican Cat Ranch have lost a bunch of players. And, they are going to go ahead and pop a crit, so there goes the heavy, and that entire push is getting shut down. This crit is going to take a bunch of ground, take a bunch of territory for the self-sustaining Mexican Cat Ranch. Meanwhile, they are trying to push the intel just barely towards mid, and if they can get away with it. This is really, I mean, it seems like this is the only reason you want to control mid is because your intel's already out there. Otherwise, it seems like teams aren't really worried too much about, you know, what kind of territory they control. But I do like the positioning right now of the blue team somewhat. They're going to have to be careful about walking out of these choke points, but they were, at least for a little while, trying to get more aggressive. Prevail, not going to be able to get away with that, though. That sentry took a lot of damage, but it is still up. And now, oh, the intel once again grabbed by that spy that is just so annoying. Bone Masher! Getting away with just perfect spy play right now. Of course, he does keep dying, but he keeps the intel right here, and that means he's keeping the red team exposed to a lot of damage. I want to find Warpy. I was told Warpy was the demo man to watch. Right now, he is considering backing away from that shutter door because that is scary. And yet, he knows that engineer was not focused on him, so he went out there and did some damage. I like it. But now we've got is it the blue intel taken? No. Yeah, okay, both intel actually grabbed now. Warpy's going to be seeing everything get destroyed over here. He wants to start chasing people down. He's done some good damage. Can he get away with getting the kills? No, he will just get taken out by this insane red attack. I like it right now. They're doing a pretty good job. Oh! However, their intel is actually in the enemy intel room. That's why they're staying here. They want to delay this as much as possible. And this is actually really good for them because they can also just grab the intel again and start walking out of here. Demoman wants to grab this, and if he can, get away with the intel. Maybe give it to the scout. Just drop it, whatever. He can take it too. It doesn't matter. I don't care. Whoever, you can do whatever you want. Good use of Girardi right now. And finally, our heavy does get taken out. And there you go. Bone Masher. Oh, he's trying to get the cap. Finally gets it. That was quite a long route to the capture zone, and in the meantime, I'm actually not entirely sure what happened there. In the meantime, that was not game over, that was just the end of the half, I think. So, it was... Yes, the score was actually 6-5 in favor of Costco. I'm sorry, I had to go back and check. So that means halftime score, 6-5. Costco in the lead. They are still in the red color as well, I think. They didn't change colors here. Sekir is in trouble, but he manages to get the needle kill and get away with the med pick. Monkey Suit now was going for the stab there on the heavy, but he's not going to be able to get it. He's just going to have to go find another place to decloak and try. Oh, you're screwed, Monkey Suit. You're so screwed. They didn't go for him? Huh. Okay, he's not screwed yet then. You can get away with that. No, it looks like... Looks like the Cat Ranch actually just wants to push forward, so they're not too worried about taking care of Monkey Suit right now. They actually want to go for the intel capture. They know they're behind a little bit. They're a little behind. Azul the Bum in some trouble here. He's going for the headshot. The clutch scout headshot, as it were, but no, he is just going to get taken out there. And now, the Cat Ranch, they've got the crits ready to go. We're going to see Warpy probably taking this crits pretty soon. He's got to be careful about getting flanked too hard here, though. He doesn't want to have to deal with his scout at all. He took him down, though. That's good. And now it's time to go find some enemies to crits into their face. Problem is, the enemy does have an Uber. Sekir actually is at 100% right now. And it's probably that regular Uber. He's been running regular Uber the entire time. So the Cat Ranch, they've got their work cut out for them. They know that if they can't get the drop on Sekir, that he's going to have an Uber, which will hard counter this crits. But only if he's in the same position. Like, if he's not around whoever's getting killed, then that's not going to happen. Usually you do kind of want to kill the enemy med with this. But in this case, maybe not. And incoming crits, but no! Warpy taken down by a sticky trap from Ricky, and all of a sudden there is the Uber to counter this. The Cat Ranch is falling apart. They have been taken down a notch or two. And that does mean that the Cat Ranch are now going to have to sit back and defend their last point here, their intel. Pepe is actually switched off to Engineer. With Attila the Bum on the sniper. So I just realized that, but Pepe had been sniping before, and now Attila's back in for sniper. Pepe is waiting for the metal to spawn, and actually, I like how he's positioned. He's just kind of sitting with his back to a wall here, so he cannot get sniped. Backstabbed. You can get sniped pretty easily with your back to a wall. come to think of it. Don't listen to SalTV for advice. Just don't do that, because you are guaranteed to get the wrong advice about everything.
If you stand with your back to a wall, you won't get sniped.
Everybody goes and tries it in a pub, and they're like, Sal, you're so wrong. I was on 2-Fort, and I stood with my back to the wall. Anyway, don't do that. It's not going to work. Stafford's Bees, though. I swear, I keep wanting to call this guy Burt's Bees, because that's totally a thing. But it's not. It's Stafford's Bees. So Stafford's Bees are going to be swarming and flying and collecting nectar here in a little while. As it looks like the blue intel has actually been taken. Stafford is considering, you know, wanting to get in here and drop down, destroy some stuff. Problem is, sounds like, oh no, another shutdown. Crits, I love it. I absolutely love it. That time around, it was the sniper who shut it down. Insom, who killed... Oh, and this time around, it's a counter. Crits coming out of Sekiro and Ricky. I like this play, too. They couldn't quite get away with killing the enemy. But actually, these are some really good stickies laid around. He doesn't actually have to detonate these. That's one thing. If you don't see any enemies around during your crits, you can just kind of take a leisurely pace and lay some crit sticky traps. Now, of course, he did go ahead and detonate those before anything happened with them, because he didn't want to sit around and wait. There is actually a pretty good opportunity for them to get in right now. Pyro is stopping a lot of damage coming in on that sentry, so I do like the Pybro technique he's using there. And Ricky taking down Cat Friend there once again. That was not a crit. I think that was probably just Girardi. But Lambert is now sneaking straight towards the intel. Actually, he's going to be coming in. Yeah, so he was waiting for the intel to return, and now he could just sneak in here. Knows that the sentry is probably not set up yet. Although it's close, and the heavy shuts him down. Lambert, you are not going to get away with Cap this time. But the soldier is going to at least try to take down that sentry. So as long as the sentry remains at level 1, I mean, it's going to be a little bit easier for the team to get in here than what if it's at, like, level 3 and wrangled. And in comes the Crits Creek once again. They're going to take down everyone in this room. And I don't even think the med is going to take a heck of a lot of damage. I got to worry about Warpy, though. That is Warpy, right? He is getting in here and doing a lot of damage. And actually, Warpy saves it. Takes down Sakura and London Calling. He's going to have to go up against his enemy Demo Man, though. And Ricky. Ricky with the kill. So, ladies and gentlemen, that was pretty ridiculous. But Ricky finally came in to clean it up. And that does mean that I think we're going to see this game... Hang on. It was Costco in the lead by a point. And Ricky just came in to try and get the intel cap. So now Costco's in the lead by 2 points. The scores are widening a little bit. Oh, man. And Insom is he's looking at whoever decides to poke their head out here. Goes ahead and Girardi's a bunch of fools. And then gets taken out himself. So no, sir, the fools actually are not that foolish. They managed to kill you. Sorry, you're going to have to deal with it. But it does look like Costco still holding mostly their position on the middle point, which means that the enemy's going to have a much tougher time getting to the intel, and they're going to have an easier time. I mean, if you can keep this forward hold, of course, you've got a much shorter distance to cover, less choke points to go through, all kinds of wonderful benefits. And in comes another crit. The first sticky actually was not crit, but he does manage to take down Pepe. The sentry gun's now down as well. He didn't manage to get the med yet, but he's going for him, and he takes down Cat Friend on the med. This crits is working out so well for Costco right now. They're killing so many fools with it. And also so many cat ranchers, I guess. But there you go, the intel is grabbed, and what sick pipes from Ricky! Oh my god, so Costco suddenly is just all over the place. They are gonna have to deal with a heavy, and this heavy is gonna die. Sorry, Stafford, but there was nothing we could do. Finally, the engineer walks in to take down Ricky, but it's too late. The intel's already back out of here once again, and that is gonna be a scout, Lambert. Grabbing it for another capture. Costco is starting to look a lot better this game. I don't know exactly at what score this ends, but Warpy is feeling a little bit sad about this, as Costco is starting to eat all of the Mexican Cat Ranch's cats. And it's gonna be a lot less self-sustaining if you don't have any cats. You gotta get more cats. It would be especially bad if they were to eat all the cats of one gender, because then, I mean, you'd still have the Cat Ranch, but you'd have to import, you know, a whole new, like, set of one gender of cat. I don't know, whatever. That would be like the worst blow you could ever make. I say this, of course, because I've played Dwarf Fortress, and you kind of have to keep the male and female cats away from each other. If you don't get the reference, don't worry about it. If you do get the reference, please tell me about the worst cat explosion you have ever witnessed, because I want to hear it. Actually, speaking of cat explosions, ever hear of the nuclear cat explosion? Because if you haven't, well, I'm going to tell you a story. while the rest of this game happens. There actually is a Gritz ready to go here. No, it's a regular Uber, so that is going to be the Cat Ranch with a regular Uber taking down a bunch of players. Stafford's B is able to get in and take the rest of it, getting himself healed up. Problem is, they aren't getting quite enough kills. They do get the intel, though, and can the Heavy just grab it from there? He wants to. Yes, he can, but he took a little bit too long doing it, and now he's dead. So the nuclear cat explosion. You can look it up on... Oh, prevail. You tried, but you did not prevail. You can look it up on the Dwarf Fortress wiki or community site or whatever yourself. But some guy decided he was going to embark with like 150 cats and only one dwarf or something. So he gets to the site, and he's got like 150 cats all set up on his wagon. And then you know what he does? He goes in and modifies the game files so that all the cats are at like 40,000 degrees Fahrenheit or whatever it is. And so you can imagine what happened next. Oh, that is so sick! Lambert, you were dead, bro. You were dead. Attila the Bum being the sickest bum of all time. So, of course, when he loaded up the game after all those cats had been set to 40,000 degrees, he literally had a cat explosion. All the cats exploded. And Attila, what are you doing? I don't even know. He was apparently listening to my story, I guess. Because that was not in any way intelligent play. So, Intel almost ready to get dropped back here. Costco has a very good defense setup right now. They know they're ahead in points, but Bone Masher! Grabbing that Intel once again and just keeping it a little bit further forward. Yarg with very good sentry positioning, though. He realizes, look, here is exactly where I need to cover. He's got a good mind for engineering. He really does. He's like, this is what I want to cover with this. This is how I want the sentry to be set up right here, just because we want to make sure that it covers this corner so that nothing can sneak in and grab the intel without taking a couple of hits. He could actually position it, like, here, but whatever. Anyway, this is going to be an attack coming in from the Cat Ranch once again, but they have to walk into an Ubered Heavy. They will pop an Uber of their own, but they've only got the Demo Man left alive. Now, this Demo Man, you can't count him out yet. He's going to be dealing a lot of damage. And there you go. He actually covered for Bone Masher to get in and grab the intel, moving it just a little bit further. The Pyro, meanwhile, are grabbing now, but he's going to get backed up against the wall by this Heavy. Costco with such a good core of their team, the Demo Man, the Heavy, and the Medic, pretty much with the sick defense of the intel. And as long as they keep doing this, defending and then using that time when the enemy wipes out to push in, Insom, you're so ridiculous. That scout, like, wobbling and then falling off, just flopping around like a ragdoll. I like the way they're using their core really effectively here on the Costco team, and I think they're probably going to win it just because of that. Their core has been so successful. They've almost got Uber ready again, but they could lose their med here. Never mind. They're not going to lose their med at all. They're, in fact, going to keep their med at 150 health. I think there's a plane or a helicopter or something going over my house right now, so that's pretty cool. It's not like it's a huge deal, but occasionally we do have to fix things on my computer, and Fraps is one of those things. I really should probably get some new programs here. Attila the Bum taken out, so apparently somebody's finally decided they're sick and tired of handing him a quarter. And they're calling GG now, so Costco may actually win this because they capped, so I guess they're calling GG. You know what? I'm going to call that GG too, because that was a really incredible game. They're saying GG, I guess. I wish the configs were a little better because we could actually tell what was happening when. But we're going to go ahead and watch this flaming scout here as I wrap us up. So that was a good game between Costco and Mexican Cat Ranch. Very close in the first half. The second half, Costco kind of broke away there and won it all. I do hope you do subscribe to youtube.com/fatmop for all of my competitive Team Fortress 2 action. And leave me some comments telling me what kind of stuff you like to see and don't like to see. I got a lot of dislikes on that new Minecraft video, but that's actually good. Because if I'm only releasing stuff that gets like 100% or 99% likes, I'm not getting useful information. It's like, okay, my current audience already likes what I'm doing. That's obvious. Let me try to do new stuff and see if they still like it. So clicking the dislike button, there is nothing wrong with doing that. If you dislike something I've put out, let me know. Okay, let me know. And that helps me make the product better. It helps me, you know, figure out which kind of videos you like and you don't like and which kind of videos I should pursue more. It's all about understanding what you want. So, anyway, I'm being told, of course, in my stream chat that Minecraft is bad and I should feel bad. But whatever, I hadn't played it in forever and I felt like making a video out of it because why not? All right, anyway, I'll see you guys later. I hope you enjoyed.